Strength's back in the cave here. Pacing around. So, I don't know about you guys, but for me, looks matter. I mean, just as much as the sound, right? I like to think that I have good taste. I'm more of the utilitarian, industrial, kind of less is more look with my equipment. And I'm not going to say it has to look exactly like that all the time, but I mean, when you look at the stuff that I own, it is very, you know, the turntable is very compact, and it's, you know, it's a beautiful piece. It just is, with the rosewood grain, simple power supply, just a simple black box. Then we go down to the E1X, and that's an industrial looking beauty. Sleek, simple, no lights on, nothing. And then you got your Techniques SL7. And then the Spatials, right? Those are just, I mean, talk about industrial elegance. I mean, I think they're gorgeous. And they've been here for years, like I try to tell people, right? So, I mean, I'm sure, you know, I've seen people in forums when I have looked at them, which is, you know, rare to none. I don't care how the hell it looks, as long as it sounds good. Well, I do. Because I'm looking at this stuff, right? And it's not cheap stuff. It's an investment. I put a lot of money into it, and I want to be able to enjoy the aesthetic of it as much as the sound. So I don't know what you guys think, but man, I tell you, there is some butt ugly equipment out there in the world that's super, super expensive, man. I'm not going to name any. Actually, why don't I? Okay, well, I already forgot the name of that one, but there's some ugly stuff. Like, in my opinion, I don't want anything that stands out on the equipment, like big, huge meters that are glowing, and there's Macintosh. Sure, that'll get some backs up. Just for that reason alone, I just don't really want it. I mean, and guys, I could buy it. I could buy almost anything and have it here to display to y'all. I got a great income. I got great credit. I could go out and get the $100,000 speakers just to come here and show them off to y'all. Why the hell would I want to do that to myself? Just the physical labor of it alone, right? So I just have my humble system that I can prove to you that I own outright and have for years. And I just got absolutely no reason to change it. And I love the look. But honestly, there's some equipment out there that is very, very expensive. And I just think, like Wilson speakers, like it seems the more expensive they get, the uglier they get. For me. Like I would prefer a Magico. I like the simple, understated look of those speakers. It's just a beautifully curved carbon fiber cabin with some nice drivers on it. I like that look over the Wilson Behemoth that got, you know, all the separate chambers and stuff. And everyone's different that way. Me, you know, I just like my Native Art collection. I don't like something that's too busy. I just, like, I even hate an LED. I just hate it. I just feel like putting tape over the Heagle down there, the V10, because it's the only thing glowing in the room. Everything else is complete black. There's nothing. And that never used to bother me before, but like everything, our taste, our palette changes for so many things. Like I used to be, it had to be silver, right? Now I prefer black. You know, it had to be ultra smooth. Now I don't like that. I like a little bit of sparkle on the top, like some life to the music. It's just funny how that is, guys, but I'd love some comments on what you guys think about aesthetics when it comes to your hard-earned money. There's some really hideous gear out there. I forget the one that's, it looks like there's copper on the chassis and there's this huge yellow thing in the middle, and you know what it is, and it's multi-thousands of dollars. I just think it almost looks kind of like a steampunk vibe. Man, it is just hideous. And then again, I've already talked about it. I hate big stuff. I just hate it. The 500-pound amplifiers and stuff like that. I'm so beyond that stuff. And again, of course, it just wouldn't work in this room. But I've had them, guys. I've had huge 2 1100-pound monoblocks in here, massive chassis. It was one of the happiest day of my journey when they came in with the dolly to buy them and get them out of here. I like sleek, cutting-edge technology. I'm on board with that, and I will continue on that path, right? The E1X is just continuing to... It just makes me happier and happier and happier. Every month I listen goes by that I've been listening to it. It's just... And it's not a company that changes the models like socks. That's been out... I consider it a platform, the E1X platform. Like, it's been out here for... It's been out for probably five years now, I think, since that first came out. And then the higher end stuff's even been current for longer than that. So I know it's a little bit of a jump all over the place topic, but it's mostly about aesthetics. To me, they matter just as much as the sound. I want to be able to look at the speakers and look at the components and just, and not have them like dominate the room, kind of just disappear in there. But I don't know. I'd love to hear what others have to say on it. I think it's a good topic. It may not get views, and that's okay. But for those that do watch me and support the channel with the super thanks and show the love financially, it means a lot to me, guys. Like, that, I don't have a Patreon and all that other stuff, but it's nice to get the odd coffee bought for me. And that's the way I look at it. I try to do the best I can here without having things provided. There will be things coming down the line that I will, you know, evaluate here for the public, just because I'm keen on the product, right? And it's something that I would think of about buying, you know. Otherwise, it's very difficult for the channel to run the way I do it, you know. And there's lots of subs out there doubting, you know, that I'll be able to continue to do it. And that's okay. I'm not after the numbers. I'm really not. I actually make some money doing this, you know, some okay money, you know. And people would think, well, how does he make any money? He gets only, on a good day, 1,500 views on a video. How? Well, work smart, not hard. How's that? But anyway, yeah, I'd love to know. I'm not going to get into bashing certain brands on what I feel is hideous to look at. I did mention Wilson, and that's as far as I'm going to go. Yeah, I don't know. I just think these guys, whoever they use to visibly draw out a component on what it's going to aesthetically look like, Some of them have very, very good taste, and I think Belcanto is one of the most tasteful looking, some of the most tasteful looking equipment out there. I mean, good on them, right? It's the same as someone designing a running shoe or a car. Like, they sit down with a pen and paper, obviously, and they draw it out, you know? So anyway, that's about it on this one. Like and subscribe if you like audio shrink, what I'm doing here. Cheers.